Senator Hoylman.
Explanation, please.
Senator Hoylman would like an explanation.
Yes. Mr. President, this bill would require all non-municipal animal sheltering and rescue organizations to register with the Department of Agriculture and Markets prior to receiving exemptions from licensing and inspection under the New York State Pet Dealer Program.
Would the sponsor yield to a few questions?
I will, Mr. President.
I lost my question.
Senator Boyle yields.
No question.
He would yield. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Through you, Mr. President.
I thought you were doing calisthenics there.
I lose my glasses like 10 times a day, but that's okay. Could the sponsor describe under existing law what the ramifications are for being a pet dealer?
Senator Boyle?
I'm sorry, I missed the question. Could you repeat that?
Oh, yeah. Through you, Mr. President, could the sponsor describe what the ramifications are for being a pet dealer currently?
Well, the current pet dealers are not what we're talking about. We're talking about those that are animal rescue and non-governmental shelters who are transporting animals. The pet dealers, licensed pets, are already covered under the existing law.
Yeah. Through you, Mr. President, with the sponsor, continue to yield.
Senator Boyle, do you yield?
Yes.
Senator yields.
So what does the legislation do in terms of exemption for municipal pounds, shelters, non-for-profit animal rescue organizations?
Through you, Mr. President. What we're seeing is a lot of these organizations do tremendous work rescuing and transporting animals. Unfortunately, there have been a few bad actors, and what some of the dealers have done, they've basically retired, if you will, and got into not-for-profit status, and they're no longer regulated by the state ag department, and that's what we want to do. It's basically a loophole that we're trying to close to require that these not-for-profits are covered when they're transporting animals so we can make sure that they're being treated humanely.
Through you, Mr. President. Or would the sponsor continue to yield?
Senator Boyle, do you yield? Senator Boyle yields.
Through you. So this loophole that you say exists would require, as I understand it, these entities, nonprofits, animal rescue organizations, adoption organizations, to register with the state ag department. Does it establish any standards of care for these animals?
They would come under the same standard of care as the organizations and pet dealers that are regulated now. We've had a number of organizations supporting and advocating for this, including the SPCA, New York State Animal Protection Federation, New York Veterinary Medical Society, and a number of other organizations throughout the state of New York, looking to make sure that these animals that are being covered by not-for-profits, by the rescue organizations, and the non-municipal shelters are being treated correctly.
Would the sponsor continue to yield?
Senator Boyle, do you yield?
I do.
Senator
yields. Mr. President, but isn't this new standard, isn't it lower than the pet dealer standard? Is that correct?
It's not complete. Licensing, it is a slightly lower standard, but we just want to make sure we know who these entities are. Right now, there's no record of them whatsoever.
Do you yield, Senator Boyle?
Continue.
So I understand, as the sponsor's memo states, that many have called for the establishment of animal care and facility standards in law to improve minimum requirements for those currently regulated and cover a much larger percentage of animal shelters and rescues, if not the full spectrum. So you're suggesting something less than the current pet dealer standard, just to be clear, for the municipal adoption organizations, non-for-profit animal rescue entities as and such?
Through you, Mr. President, the non-municipal entities, yes. We want to make sure the state ag department has a record and knows who these individuals are. And I say the vast majority of them are doing great work with these animals. Unfortunately, we've had a couple cases throughout our state of companies that, or organizations, should I say, that are not doing the right thing, and we have no record of them. This would allow state agriculture and markets oversight with them, maybe not to the extent we have with pet dealers, but we don't want to make the perfect the enemy of the good in this case.
Sponsor, continue to yield.
Senator Boyle, do you yield?
I continue to yield, yes.
Yields.
Through you, Mr. President. But why not just establish the same standards for animal care? After all, this is Animal Protection Week. Why not establish the same standards for these non-municipal shelters, not-for-profit animal rescue organizations, or adoption organizations? Why not just make all animals treated equally?
Yeah. Through you, Mr. President, I'm very much supportive of it. This is what we could get passed in both houses of the legislature at this point in time, but be happy to work with the good senator in doing just that.
Sponsor, continue to yield?
I do.
Well, yields.
Who would oversee the actual new standards, lesser than they are than pet dealers, for this new class of shelters?
It's the Department of Agriculture and Markets.
Sponsor, continue to yield?
Yes.
Senator Boyle yields.
Is there anything envisioned in the legislation that would set forth, since it is an entirely new area of oversight for the department, anything that sets forth what those standards might be, how often they have to, seek oversight from the adoption organization in the bill, or is it left unwritten?
Through you, Mr. President, it is just a certification, so the standards are not there. But importantly, if they do not register, the registration fee is only $100. It's a nominal amount, about the amount of perhaps one adoption. But the penalties are similar to the current legislation, between $100 and $1,000 per act.
Final question, if
final question?
Absolutely.
So we're exempting from the definition of pet dealers these entities that provide their not-for-profit, duly incorporated societies for prevention of cruelty to the animals, humane societies, animal protective associations. Again, why not just put them all under the same standard? Your response was that it's the only thing we could get moving in the other house, but why not introduce a bill to that effect in this chamber?
Through you, Mr. President, Senator Hoylman is saying that we're exempting. They're exempted now, and that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to avoid them being exempted. We want to make them certify so officials at the Agriculture and Markets Department know who they are and can keep an eye on them. Do I think we should go further in terms of the standards? Absolutely. But this will allow us at least to start watching them and looking into what they're doing, because right now it's a blank sheet out there. They don't know what's going on, and we found that 40% of the pet dealers in this state have gone under in the last few years. So there's a huge number of animals being transported, but the state government has no idea who is doing it and under what circumstances. So this will not really exempt it. It will actually create more oversight and protect the animals.
On the bill.
Senator Hoylman, on the bill.
I wanted to thank the sponsor for his responses. I think we should be reconsidering whether to exempt these entities that many of us have had contact with in terms of adopting pets. We should reconsider whether we should be exempting them from the standards of pet dealers. I think today is all about protecting animals, not exempting organizations that may have the best intentions but may not meeting the standards in the state of New York for the care and oversight of animals. I'll be voting in the negative. I'm hopeful that the sponsor would bring forward legislation that would set forth a comparable standard for all pet dealers across the board. I think that is the intention, but we should not be meeting anyone halfway when it comes to protecting animals. So I'll be voting in the negative, Mr. President. Thank you.